After studying this module, you shall be able to know the concept of fugacity, determine the coefficient of fugacity, learn about the third law of thermodynamics, know about the concept of residual entropy. The concept of fugacity was introduced by an American chemist, G.N. Lewis. It is used for representing the real behavior of van der Waals gases, which is different from the behavior of ideal gases. At constant temperature, the variation of free energy with pressure is given by equation 1 as dg by dp at constant T is equal to V. For 1 mole of an ideal gas, V stands for the molar volume, and thus we can write it as dg at constant temperature is equal to RT dP by P as our equation 2. Similarly, for n moles of gas, the equation turns into dg at constant temperature equals to nRT dP by P, which can be written as nRT ln P. This is our equation 3. Integrating this equation 3, we get g equals to g star plus nRT ln P, in which g star is the integration constant, is the free energy of n moles of the gas when pressure P is unity. This equation 4 gives the free energy of ideal gas having n number of moles at temperature T and pressure P. Now, integrating the equation between the limits P1 and P2 while keeping the temperature constant, we get delta G equals to integration from P1 to P2 nRT dP by P, which gives nRT ln P2 by P1 as our equation 5. Similarly, if our n is equal to 1, then delta G is equal to RT ln P2 by P1. This is our equation 6. The equations are not valid for real gases. For making these equations valid for real gases, the fugacity function was introduced. It substitutes pressure in equation 3, giving dg at constant temperature equals to nRT d of ln F as our equation 7. Then equation 4 becomes g equals to g star plus nRT ln F as our equation 8. When F is equal to 1, then g is equals to g star, that is, g star is the free energy of n moles of a gas when its fugacity becomes 1. Thus, fugacity acts as the fictitious pressure, that is, it plays the role of pressure and is not equal to actual pressure of real gas. Therefore, it can be regarded as the corrected pressure for the real gas. Now, integrating equation 7 between fugacities F1 and F2 while keeping the temperature T constant, we get delta G equals to nRT ln F2 by F1 as our equation 9. Similarly, for 1 mole of the gas, the equation becomes delta G equals to RT ln F2 by F1 as our equation 10. The two equations are valid for real gases. Now, we shall learn about the fugacity coefficient gamma. Fugacity coefficient is defined as the ratio of fugacity of a real gas to the actual pressure P of the gas. It is represented as F divided by P equals to gamma. This is our equation 11. It is the measure of deviations of a real gas from ideal gas behavior. The units of fugacity and pressure are same. Therefore, fugacity coefficient will be a pure number. At extremely low pressures, when P is approaching zero, fugacity coefficient approaches to unity. All the gases approach ideality under this pressure range. That is, F by P limit P tending to zero is equal to 1. This is our equation 12. Therefore, at low pressure, fugacity becomes equal to pressure. Fugacity becomes different from pressure only in the high pressure range. Now, we shall study about the determination of fugacity of a gas. For 1 mole gas, we can write g equals to g star plus RT ln F as our equation 13. differentiating equation with respect to pressure, keeping temperature and number of moles of various components to be constant, we have dg by dp at constant T is equal to RT into d by dp of ln F as our equation 14. And we know that dg by dp at constant temperature is equal to volume. This is our equation 15. Equating the two equations, we get our equation 16 as d by dp of ln F at constant T is equals to V by RT. At specified temperature, the equation becomes RT d of ln F equals to V dp. This is our equation 17. Let alpha be the quantity which defines the deviation from ideal behavior. Substituting for ideal gas, V equals to RT by P, the quantity alpha is given by alpha equals to RT by P minus V. This is our equation 18. Multiplying the equation by dP, we get alpha dP equals to RT into dP by P minus V dP as equation 19. Combining equations 17 and 18, we may write RTD of ln F is equal to RT dP by P minus alpha dP, or D of ln F equals to D of ln P minus alpha dP by RT. This is our equation 20. Integrating this equation between the pressure range 0 to P, we write ln of F by P equals to 1 by RT integration from 0 to P of alpha dP. This is our equation 21. Here, alpha is an experimentally determined quantity measured at different pressures. Thus, according to the above equation, fugacity will be less than pressure at low pressure range, while it will be higher than pressure P at a higher pressure range. We shall see the fugacity at low pressure. At low pressure range, fugacity is found to have constant values. Under such conditions, therefore, equation 21 is ln F by P equals to alpha P by RT. This is our equation 22. At low pressure range, real gas tends to behave as an ideal gas, thus F is equal to P, or F by P is approximately equals to 1. This is our equation 23. Using the fact when x is small and approaches unity, x becomes approximately equals to x minus 1. Then we have ln of f by p equals to f by p minus 1, or f by p is equals to 1 plus ln of f by p. This is our equation 24. Using the equation 22, we get f by p equals to 1 minus alpha p by RT. This is our equation 25. By making the use of equation 18, we get f by p equals to pv by RT, or f equals to p square v by RT. This is our equation 26. Thus, by the equation obtained above, fugacity can be calculated at moderately low pressures. For 1 mole of pure gas, chemical potential becomes equal to Gibbs free energy. The change in chemical potential for the gaseous component I is given by d mu I equals to RT d ln Fi. This is our equation 27. Or it can be written as mu I equals to mu star I plus RT ln Fi. This is our equation 28, where mu I star denotes the chemical potential of the gaseous component I having the unit fugacity. Now, we shall learn about the physical significance of fugacity. Considering the system in which liquid is in contact with the vapor phase, in this water molecules in the liquid escape into the vapor phase by evaporation, while molecules in the vapor phase have the tendency to escape into liquid phase by condensation. these two escaping tendencies become equal at equilibrium. Thus, it is accepted that any substance has the tendency to escape from its state. Lewis termed this escaping tendency as fugacity. Now, we shall discuss the third law of thermodynamics. The third law of thermodynamics is formulated by German chemist Walther Nernst during the years 1906 to 1912. This law is regarding the properties of the system in equilibrium at absolute zero temperature. The statement for the third law of thermodynamics is, at absolute zero temperature, the entropy of each perfectly crystalline solid becomes zero. At absolute zero temperature, the order of the pure crystal becomes perfect, that is, of zero order and hence of zero entropy. Thus, at zero Kelvin temperature, the system must possess minimum possible energy. The statement given by Nernst and Simon is, the change in entropy related to any condensed system which is undergoing any reversible isothermal process reaches zero as the temperature at which this process is performed approaches zero. The Planck's statement. If 1 mole of a solid is heated from 0 Kelvin to some temperature T below its melting point, keeping its temperature constant, the change in entropy is given by delta S equals to ST minus S 0 Kelvin equals to integration from 0 to 2 Kelvin of CPM by T dT, or ST is equals to S at 0 Kelvin plus integration from 0 to T Kelvin of CPM by T dT. We can say that the entropy function increases with temperature. Thus, it can be minimum at absolute 0 Kelvin. Planck stated that the pure crystalline substance have the minimum entropy at absolute temperature. This is known as the third law of thermodynamics. From the equation, the third law entropy will be given as ST equals to integration from 0 to T Kelvin Cp molar by T dT. Here, ST is the entropy of the substance at temperature T and pressure P. If the pressure of the system is 1 bar, then the entropy is termed as standard entropy ST naught. Now, we shall see the determination of entropy for solids, liquids and gases. For solids, for determining the entropy, the heat capacity of solids should be known. The heat capacity of the solids is determined by the D by T cubed law, which is given by Cp molar is equals to alpha T cube, where alpha is the constant. The entropy will be given by ST equals to integration from 0 to T minimum Cp molar by T dT plus integration from T minimum to T Cp molar by T dT, which is equal to integration from 0 to T minimum Cp molar by T dT plus integration from T minimum to T Cp molar D of temperature by T, which can be further written as integration from 0 to T minimum Cp molar by T dT plus 2.303 integration from T minimum to T Cp molar D log T, where T minimum is the minimum temperature to which the value of heat capacity is available. For liquids, the entropy at temperature T is determined as follows. The solid is heated from temperature 0 Kelvin to its melting point Tm. The solid is transformed to liquid at its melting point Tm, and the liquid is heated to temperature T. Thus, by adding these three processes, we get ST equals to integration 0 to Tm Cp molar of solid by T dT plus delta H fusion by Tm plus integration from Tm to T Cp molar of liquid by T dT. For gases, similarly, the entropy will be given by ST equals to integration 0 to Tm Cp molar solid by T dT plus delta H fusion by Tm plus integration Tm to Tb Cp molar of liquid by T dt plus delta H vaporization by Tb plus integration from Tb to T Cp molar gas by T dt. Now we shall talk about the residual entropy. The entropies which are calculated using the third law of thermodynamics are known as thermal entropies. But the expression for entropy suggested by Boltzmann is given by S equals to K ln W. These entropies are called as statistical entropies. Statistical entropies are larger in value as compared to the thermal entropies. The difference ranges between 3.1 to 4.8 joules per Kelvin per mole. It was found that the entropy of the substances like H2, D2, CO, NO, N2O, H2O, etc. are not zero at zero Kelvin. Such entropies are known as residual entropies. Their existence is mainly due to the alternative arrangements of the molecules in solid. Now, we shall summarize what we have learnt in this module. Fugacity is used for representing the real behavior of van der Waals gases, which is different from the behavior of ideal gases. Fugacity coefficient is defined as the ratio of fugacity of a real gas to the actual pressure P of the gas. It is represented as F by P equals to gamma. The third law of thermodynamics is formulated by German chemist Walther Nernst. This law states that at absolute zero temperature, the entropy of each perfectly crystalline solid becomes zero. According to the third law of thermodynamics, the entropy is given by the following expression. St equals to integration from 0 to T Kelvin Cp molar by T dt.